don't recognize me because I'm wearing a new dress. And little cheer captain and MC Swag, we're all wearing new dresses, so we are going to teach you how to make LOL clothes. Yay! It's so fun to make these fancy dresses. Look at how cute little cheer captain is. Her shoes don't quite match this elegant off-the-shoulder dress. So let's take these shoes off because it looks so much better. And let's put black shoes on her because we have these little black shoes that we got from one of our baby LOLs. And that looks so much prettier with her dress, doesn't it? Or maybe we can borrow Royal Highness's high heels for this outfit, because it would be so much cuter if she was wearing these pink high heels with this outfit. So who wants to know how to learn how to make these dresses? And they're so easy to make. There's no sewing, no glue involved at all. So let's get started. So who should we make the dress for? Maybe we should make a dress for this Royal Highness. And it's actually Royal Hiney. Royal Hiney. And I will teach you how to make this dress first. So all you need is some balloons. Look at these pretty, pretty balloons. So you can just pick a balloon, the color of the dress you want to make. What color dress should we make, Royal Hiney? Since she has pink hair, maybe like a purple dress would fit her really nicely. So let's take this purple balloon. Is this beautiful or what? And we're just going to stretch it just a little. So stretch that balloon, and you're just going to need a scissor. And we're going to cut. So if you are too young to be using scissors, the parental supervision is always required if you cannot use scissors by yourself. Since we're making this dress, we want to measure. So we're just going to cut like straight like this. A little longer is always better than a little shorter. So it's just like a straight cut like that. And now we're just going, this is like the simplest dress ever. And we are going to cut little armholes. And then to cut little armholes, you're just going to do, just like these little moon shapes right under your slits. So really small. You see how small that was? And then we're just going to cut it out. Like that. Doesn't have to be perfect. You can do the same thing on the other side. These little moon shapes. And now we're going to put the dress on Royal Hiney. So we're going to take her dress off. We're going to just slip this on. Okay, so we slipped it on her, and you can see that it's not quite the same on the neck. And that's when you are just going to take a little scissor, and you're going to snip it. And you're going to kind of just alter it to make it look more natural on the neckline. So I'm just going to take my scissor and then make it a little V over here to give her a more natural neck shape. And then you can just go around, and if it's still a little too tall, you can trim it all the way around. So just keep adjusting and cutting however you want to make the dress. And if the dress was too long or too short, you could just kind of roll it up or roll it down to the length, or you can even just cut it. So that's up to you. So I'm just going to roll it up a little because I wanted to make this more of like a summery dress. So there we have our first dress. Oh my gosh, look at how cute she is in her little dress. And these are great because when you stick them in the water, these balloons are just waterproof too. So let's get on to our next dress. Royal Hiney, do you love your dress? Oh yes, she does. She lost her pacifier on the process. So let's put that pacifier back. And then let's make our second dress. So our second dress is very similar to our first dress, but we are just going to put the little, I don't know what this part of the balloon is, the mouthpiece of the balloon on the top instead of the bottom. So let's find another little doll. What about Majorette? Majorette needs a dress. Should we make a pink dress for Majorette, or this maroon dress, or this pink polka dot one? I guess we'll just do this maroon dress. That'll be cute. Oh, we have a green balloon too. Oh, the green kind of will be super cute on Majorette. So actually, let's do the green balloon on Majorette. So take off Majorette's dress. Oh, take off her boots because it'll be easier to dress her. And we are going to make another cut. So again, measuring, just cutting like that. And we're just going to make two little armholes, little half moons on the top. Different. So if you wanted to do both of these up, you can put it up, or you can leave one of them down. And you can even leave these little creases in there, because it makes it like a little different style dress. And you see how we did put another armhole there, but you won't even be able to see the hole. So we just made like a different style dress. So this is such a versatile way of making little dresses. Oh my gosh, look at that. They're both in beautiful evening gowns now. So that's our other dress that we just made. Again, if you wanted to make this dress look like this one, just pull this arm through the little hole, and it'll look like that one. And now let's make our last and final dress. Oh, this is our last and final dress. And this is kind of like a dress slash jacket, because if we want to look at how this dress is, you take the rubber band off, it actually opens up like that. So it's kind of like a little, I was trying to make a little jacket, but it turned out to be this cute little dress. And this is just like a rainbow loom rubber band, or you can just use a hair band. So let me, and we will make it because you just use the bottom of this one. So which color should we use? Since I have the bottom, let's make it purple. And who's gonna wear that purple dress? Should we have Merbaby? Oh my gosh, and Merbaby's purple hair will match perfectly with this purple dress. So we have to definitely make it for Merbaby. Let me just clean out my area a little. It's getting very messy here, my design studio. And we'll have Merbaby here, and we're gonna make her the purple one because it'll match so perfectly. And we're just gonna take our balloon, and this is the balloon where we cut it off, the top off, and we're just going to cut it like 3/4 of the way. I guess it's more of like half, right? So we just cut it like that, and we're gonna use the top part of this, and we're going to cut a very small semicircle, just like where the neck is. So just like that. So this is how I came up with this dress at first, and maybe we'll make a different type of dress altogether, because this is all about having fun and experimenting, and these balloons are super inexpensive. You can totally get them at your Target, your Party City, so nothing fancy here. So you can actually take this and make a little skirt for her. So this is actually another outfit. Maybe we will stick to this one as a skirt, but she needs a top. So let's see, what top do we have? We're just gonna do the same thing. I just love this. This is so easy and so fun to do. Inexpensive too, low investment. And if you make a mistake, just grab another balloon, or you could just make it into something else like I just did. Like, you don't know. You just cut it and then you can use all the little pieces. Like this piece, maybe we can make something out of this piece too. This could probably be another little dress. Oh my gosh, like over here. Let's try that. We're gonna have so much clothes and not enough LOL dolls. This is the top and the bottom of the balloon, right? I'm gonna take this, and I'm just working on the fly. Let's see if we could just cut a little C on this side, a little C on that side, and see what we will make with this. On without the shoes. So it's not that cute. It doesn't fit that well. Let's see, how can we alter it to make it fit better? Let's try cutting a little neck. We cinch it. Let's get a little rubber band. So I have all these colors of rubber bands. Maybe we will use, I was thinking the gray, but maybe I'll just use green because it'll blend in more. This green, this lime green. Let's see if we cinch it, if it'll do anything to the dress. That's kind of cute. It still is a little big, but oh my gosh! See, sometimes just putting a little rubber band around it, it makes her into another dress. Oh my gosh! So there's our other dress. And that one's actually very similar to this one, so let me just teach you how to make this one now. So this is Cozy. I can't remember her name now. I'm just blanking on names. Cozy. Figure skater, cozy something. I will look it up. If you guys know, please write in the comments below. I am just drawing a blank. So this is just making like a little jacket type deal for her. And it is the same concept where we're just going to, this one we're actually going to cut down the middle. And it doesn't have to be exact because you see this a little asymmetrical. And we're going to do armholes. This purple on her pink hair kind of worked out. Oh my gosh, this makes the coolest little cape. I did not even intend on doing this because I wanted to look like that, but I think that this is an awesome outfit in itself. She has to wear a shirt underneath because she can't go out dressed like that. Okay, we're putting her, everyone is wearing all everyone else's clothes, so this is MC Swag's outfit, right? But we are going to just have everyone wear anything. I don't know which one. Kind of like Elsa's when she's like saying let it go throughout the thing. So that's cool too. And I never showed you how to make this. So let me, I guess we'll do with this one. And this one doesn't look as cool as when I look at all the other ones that I've made now, huh? This one is kind of just like bleh, but I'll show you how to make that anyway. Because that was my intention in the beginning. And I ran out of LOL dolls. Oh, I know. I still have Baby Cat. I'll show you on Baby Cat. Okay. Just cutting out the top of the balloon. Again, we're just going to cut this over here. A really small hole. And then we've got Baby Cat. Let's take off Baby Cat's outfit. And this doesn't really match at all. This color does not go with Baby Cat at all. But that's fine. Long compared to this one, or they're just different styles, but if you wanted it shorter, you can just cut it shorter. The shorter ones, I think, look a little better. So I'm just gonna take my scissor and trim it a little. So there, that is that dress. So I hope you enjoyed these LOL clothes. They were so fun to make. Remember, just simple, easy balloons. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you want to see how to make more different types of LOL clothes using different materials, be sure to write in the comments what you'd want to see, what kind of clothes you want to see, and I will try to make them. So look at all of our dolls in their new outfit. Tell me which one you like the best. I think I like this one. This one was so simple, and it was kind of like an accident that I made it. But super cute looking. She's like a little hula dancer. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. Be sure to like, subscribe, and comment, and stay tuned for my big, big LOL giveaway. It was Shopkins, but I think LOLs are so much more popular now. Thanks for watching, and bye now.